one off. That sucks.
There we go. Greetings, everyone. How's it going? So we're just looking at an eBay listing that someone sent me. does something look familiar? maybe a little familiar there.
Sold.
What do you think? Is that, a little familiar?
So you choose. Oh God, that's great. Sorry.
Somebody basically ripped off my old Facebook profile picture and put it up as their eBay listing for selling their collection.
Here's the thing, but you only buy one DVD with this thing.
Yes, you're not getting the whole collection for 99
cents. But it's misleading as fuck.
And I swear, it's not me. I'm not selling my collection. You can see it's still there.
Especially not in the UK.
It's not going anywhere.
Someone should just go and buy, like, actually go through the process and buy everything they have and not pay them.
That's right. See, and if I was selling my collection, yes, it would not be on eBay UK.
Be either CA or CA.com, I'd imagine.
Yeah, it would most likely be CA. With cross postings on .com. So, yeah, what the fucking fuck? Like, I just...
Did you report it?
Oh, yeah. Well, I sent him a message saying, please remove my picture because you didn't get my permission and it misrepresents what you're selling. So we'll give him a little bit of time. If he removes it, great. If not, then I'll report him.
I would have reported him. Yeah. I have no leniency to assholes. Keep leniency to assholes and they get away with shit, you know? They're just going to use it.
That's true.
Yeah, by the way, the last question on that was, name the most dominant character in this list. And it was like Michael Jordan, Babe Ruth, Michael Phelps, and then Wayne Gretzky.
Yep.
So of course I chose Wayne Gretzky.
Yes.
I got antibiotics for my not cancer.
For your not cancer. Well, glad to hear you don't have cancer of the eyeball. That's good. Just some weird thing, apparently.
Death by eyeball.
you get a glass eye like Sammy Davis Jr. You can, like, take it out, stick it in people's faces, and then show them the gory eye socket hole.
You know, it's funny, is there's a foreign body behind my left eye, which means they might actually have to remove my eye and cut it out. Not the eye, the
They would have to take the eye. Well, they'd have to get at it, but then they'd put it back.
Exactly, And I would be like, please, for the love of God, take a photo of my face with my eye hanging out. I want that to be my Facebook photo. That's what I'm going to tell them. I just want that to be my Facebook photo for the next X many years.
I was going
to
say, that'll be your new Facebook photo,
That's right. That'll be my fan page photo, too. A fucking tube and, like, my eyeball just dangling there. Like, fuck yeah. Fucking brilliant, man.
Cass will immediately block you.
What do you mean, fan page? You just unfollow the fan page.
There you go.
If you want to know why I'm late, look at everything I had to print out on the world's slowest computer printer.
Is it dot matrix?
The world's slowest computer. No.
No, it's just an old printer, I imagine.
So, I realized that I had not yet ripped the DVD of Five Faces of Darkness, so I am doing that right now. By the way, we're watching Five Faces of Darkness today.
That's in four parts, right?
It's five. Five parts.
It's for five episodes of season three. It's very easy.
Yes. 16.
Because I think Netflix has it in four parts.
Oh.
It shouldn't possibly be in four parts.
Okay, it's in five parts.
Five episodes. Okay, good.
Like, it could possibly be in four parts unless they named an episode.
Unless they combined two of them.
Well, that's true. I'm sure that's happened too.
The Four Faces of Darkness.
The four. Yes, each part details one face.
Yay, new theme. My preferred theme, actually.
Yeah.
And sitting in my cupboard right now is the greatest thing to ever happen to mankind.
Oh, cool.
That would be bacon jerky.
So it looks like I have the commercials, concept art, fan art gallery, fan film, From the Files of Teletrain 2, Into the Creation Matrix, PSAs, and Autobots fans. Is that all the special features from that box set?
What? Sorry?
So the special features I have are commercials, concept art gallery, fan art, the fan film, Files from the Teletrain 2, Into the Creation Matrix, PSA, and the Autobots Decepticons, the fans, special feature. What am I missing from the big set?
The big thing you're missing is the roundtable discussion with all the voice actors.
Ah.
That's a big one.
Me up with that.
Yeah.
Down that person has a...
It's like, I don't know, half hour or so, all the voice actors reminiscing about the show and stuff like that. It's awesome. It's so much fun.
Sadly,
Peter Cullen was one of the few that could not join them, but they do have Frank Welker and,
cool.
and Michael Bell and most of the other guys. What do you want?
You got the Paranormal Activity side story, the Warren Cullen.
Ooh, the
lenticular flip cover. Takes place between 4 and 5.
Cool. That's pretty neat.
You got the digital code for me? Justin?
I will. I haven't even opened it yet. Jesus.
Oh, I thought it had been open. Chill. I didn't know. You're just holding up a DVD.
I will murder you. No.
I will club you to death with your own shows. I had to kill them with their own shows. Ogenix does not believe he's going to be able to join us tonight. Just a heads up. He's doing some recording with a with some friend, whatever.
That's okay, we got Dean. Dean can give us the links. Dean.
Says the entrance recording thing.
He's like, fucking assholes.
Good. Do you use any photos or text from other eBay users or websites is expressly against the terms of seller's service on eBay.
Yep.
So...
Because they had a lot of people, it used to be that you had to provide your own hosting service for photos, but then there was a lot of people misrepresenting their stuff, so now they have that rule so that if some of you take it from one of those sites, they can take it down, which means you can't even use it on your own personal area and or personal photo albums until you are done with your listing or whatever. So. Totally your
buddy. I thought this was the first one. Well, apparently not. I had the titles all mixed up. I thought I Want to Believe was the first X-Files movie, but I was wrong. Okay.
What? No, it's Fight the Future.
Yeah. My bad.
I Want to Believe is... I really liked it, and a lot of fans didn't like it, and it was a shame. That's how it goes, though.
Yes, also Halloween
2. Yay, you get the out of print Halloween 2. The out of print, yet ridiculously cheap still because there's still a lot of out in circulation.
I see.
Where did I put the pen that I had? Where? Pen! Hello! Fine, fuck you, pen. Here we go. I like using an Allen wrench to open things up. A wrench so good they named it after Allen. We know how great that guy is.
Somebody went grocery shopping today.
I watched Ender's Game today, Sean.
Oh, he did!
Yeah.
Awesome.
Now guess what my rating is out of 10. Go ahead, just guess.
Out of 10, 7.
Dead on.
Well, there you go.
I'm a very harsh critic, though, so everyone should know that. I'm very harsh in my criticism.
I know this. Cause I did not like
the main actor. But.
Really? Why? What was there something specific about him?
Just he didn't feel like when I looked at him, he didn't look like Ender. He didn't feel like Ender to me, right? Mm-hmm. And like his voice was really aggravating. He grew on me by the end of the movie. But like I didn't hate him. I just did not like him.
Like acting wise, I thought he did a great job.
Yeah, except for the part where he gets really angry and his voice gets all squeaky. That was like, that just made me laugh. But near the end, you know, I was like, oh, really? You just had to get really high pitched with that? Seriously. You guys should appreciate the fact I'm here. Lady friend almost joined me for Netflix until I mentioned live streams, and she's like, oh, I don't want to interrupt. Like, damn it! Damn it! Damn
lady
it!
Lady friend? What the fuck?
Yes, my lady friend.
Is it one from before, or...?
It's one of the same ones, yes.
Okay.
It's the only... There's only two people who I would refer to my lady friend.
I had to tear into the watch mode.
It's the one you've never met. There we go. That's the way to define what you're doing.
So, yeah. So okay. So you didn't care for Ender. What else? Like, what is?
No, that was a big thing. I also the compressed time was kind of bothersome.
Yeah.
Here's your one match, and suddenly you're fighting two armies. Like, what?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah. They really condensed the battle room scenes.
Yeah. Scenes. It was just under 2 hours, and that movie could have easily been 2.5 hours and just fine.
This is what I said.
Two more battles in the battle room to kind of give progression would have been perfect.
Yeah.
And one or two extra battles in the simulation room.
Yeah.
That would have made the, not even like whole battles, like chunks of it, so you get more passage of time. So it doesn't feel like an abrupt, by the way, it's been months. And some of the stresses of being a team that's never lost really should have been more pushed onto them. Like, it should have been more expressed. Because that was the thing about Dragon Team, is they didn't lose.
That's right.
You know?
That's true.
And I started Ender Shadow today, too.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Just had to after watching the movie.
No, I just got the book yesterday. I was gonna read it regardless if I had started the movie or not.
Yeah. I'm a little past halfway. So...
Cool. Oh, and so, I got the Transformers bundle from Humble Bundle.
Oh, you did, eh? Cool.
Yes.
Yeah. I'm really enjoying Ender's Shadow so far. I'm into the part now that really parallels Ender's Game, and it's interesting to see familiar events, but from Bean's perspective.
That's what I'm looking forward to.
Yeah, it's really cool. He has a really interesting backstory too. I really liked his backstory.
Ooh, I can add RoboCop to my wish list. It's
sweet. So Disney will finish with the rip here, and then we can probably get into the show about 5 minutes.
No, whatever.
So, yeah.
Wait, Dean has it. Never mind.
So, yeah, I had to tear into Watch Mojo today. I ran across a top 10 anticipated but disappointing movies.
Ah.
Number 10 was Tron Legacy.
What? But it was awesome.
Right? Here's my comment. It is the top comment right now. I put paused at 46 seconds. Yeah. Tron Legacy, really? I put that movie was fucking fantastic and extremely faithful to the original movie.
Yes.
I put what about Skyline? That shit biscuit was hyped to shit and looked cool until you watched it and wondered what kind of half baked moron came up with the plot and what version of After Effects did they steal the explosions from? But I did jump through the list to see what else was there, and for most of it was okay. I mean, they talked about other movies like Transformers and The Hangover 2 and stuff like that. I put Tron Legacy, just no. I put Indiana Jones and the Kingdom of the Crystal Skull. I put apparently some people never knew about the 1930s cheesy action heroes that the series of the movie is based on. And Matrix Revolutions, I put, was not great, but not disappointing. I go, all those
long. That's how I describe Revolutions.
It was not great, but not disappointing at all. But all those movies should not be on the list. They did mention one that I know will make you guys pretty mad. What is it? Crystal Skull. They have some honorable mentions on here. Some of the honorable mentions were Spider-Man 3, X-Men The Last Stand.
Fair enough. Fair enough on all those, yeah.
Oh, The Godfather 3.
That gets really? Shit on a lot. Mm-hmm. I haven't seen it, so I can't really say one way or the other. I've heard that the only way in which it is a bad movie, per se, is that it pales in comparison to other Godfather films. But that compared to other films, it's still pretty damn good.
I noticed when I watched this video, they said the same thing for every single movie.
Really?
Shoddy acting. They used that exact word.
Shoddy acting.
For every single one of them.
Shoddy. It's very shoddy.
Shoddy acting? Do you understand? Shoddy. They don't understand what shoddy acting was. Is. Like.
Yeah.
Dumb plot was
like people,
one.
People who don't know what a plot hole is.
Dumb plot? That is the worst fucking...
I'm just hoping they didn't say plot holes.
Mm-hmm. Plot holes. Big plot holes. Huge holes of plot.
Huge holes of plot.
But...
Plot so holes of... I mean, personally for me... Falls out.
And I've made this clear to people... that I didn't much care for Kingdom of the Crystal Skulls, but I notice what kind of movie it was trying to be.
Yes.
And so, but I just personally didn't care for it. Would I put it at anticipated but disappointing? No.
In all honesty, I was one of those people who raged against it when it came out, right?
Yeah.
But in hindsight, mm-hmm. I was wrong.
Oh, so. Yeah. Well, then.
It's a better movie than I ever gave it credit for. It's just, I was being a shit, you know?
Well, more of a shit.
I was being a shit, period. I stand by my statement. Oh, cool, Bad Grandpa's coming next. Sweet.
What? Bad Grandpa?
I'm getting Bad Grandpa next to after Ender's Game goes back. And then I'm getting Hangover Part 3, so I can finally finish that trilogy.
Awesome. Mm-hmm. I still haven't seen the second one.
Yeah, same here.
Oh, I really liked the second one. I was like, oh, it's a Hangover, but, you know, different. Just the same movie again. Like, what the fuck do you expect? It's about dudes get really drunk at a fucking bachelor party and forget what happens, and they have to discover what happens. There's only so many ways you can do that story. Just enjoy the fucked up shit that happens.
It's like, well, yeah, obviously the basic, premise is going to be similar. That's just what it is, but it's about the stupid shit that happens that's different, you know.
Nobody complains when Jackass 1, 2, and 3 are all the same
and
fucking 2.5 thing.
And 3.5.
Exactly.
Yeah.
It's like, I want to get, it's funny.
Exactly. I need to get Bad Grandpa 0.5.
It's not a film, you know, they're not, it's Hangover is not a film aspiring to be art or unique. It's aspiring to make you laugh. Sit and enjoy the fucking movie. It's okay.
You called it a film, and that bothers me.
Shut
the fuck up.
Enjoy the funny.
The first movie was brilliant. Absolutely fucking hilarious.
Oh, yeah.
The second one, okay. Third one went a little overboard when they did the same thing a third time. For me, that's where the negativity comes in. It's like, how many times can you do this?
Mm-hmm.
You know, how many times can they get drunk and forget and wind up somewhere? I mean, how many times is it going to get that bad? I mean, it's just Jesus.
Have you been to a frat party? It gets that bad every week for some of these guys. So, trust me, it can happen, especially when you're dumb and drunk and you don't know self-control when you get intoxicated, which these guys clearly don't. God. And Hangover 2 was ridiculous. It was so ridiculous. You couldn't take it seriously for 1 second. It's so fucking funny. Because it just... It's like, you know, from a... Here's logical things that happen, and then the fucking Hangover 2 is like way the fuck over there. And you just enjoy it as a fucking ridiculous comedic farce. Just... It's fun.
I just couldn't get over the fact that I had seen it before. And it's just like... It was funny once... It was really funny once, not twice.
I'm not going to own the movie or anything. I enjoyed watching it, you know.
I'll own it eventually.
Yeah, someone gifted it to me. I wouldn't complain. I would own it. And I would like it, you know.
I have sort of my stupid comedy section.
See, I went on Jackass. That's the stupid comedy I can watch over and over and over and over
Absolutely.
Again.
Absolutely. By the way, speaking of Jackass, they are re-releasing the TV show sets in a complete box set.
I really want them to do them Blu-ray, so it's one disc.
It's a... Well, that's not going to happen. It appears to be just a repackaging of the previous four volumes. So it's the three volumes plus the lost episodes. So just all together in one box set. So if you don't have it, that's another way you can get it. I'm not sure when it comes out. Soon-ish. Okay. This year.
Because I want that. Because I don't have that.
Yeah, I thought of you when I saw that. It's like, oh. I bet Skin Slip looks like that.
Yeah. The other sets have been on my wish list for a long time on Amazon. Yeah. Oh, so they have a when you go to your wish list on Amazon, near the top underneath the title, there's a thing that says how much you want to buy the whole list, and they click it and it shows you the value of the entire list.
Oh my god, really?
My movies and TVs list is 918 items long. It's $18,695.
Awesome.
To own the entire list.
It's not too bad.
$18,000.
That's crazy.
Yeah. So it wants me to be my sugar daddy. Just saying.
$18,000 and everything ever wanted.
Imagine coming home and there's a fucking crate on your porch every day for like 3 months. Here's your crate of like 100 movies. Like, Jesus Christ.
Yeah. My main wish list of 15 items, 15, is worth $976.
Wow. See, at least that's doable.
That's a computer, isn't it?
No, that is two different kinds of boxes of Japanese Kit Kats.
Kit Kats, yeah.
Those two. That is a LG 47-inch 3D 120Hz TV.
There you go. That's
another Vizio 48-inch 1080p TV. PlayStation 4 camera, a Coolmaster Hyper 212 Evo, a Ricoh Magic RKM MK8025, which is it's an Android stick. The 30th Anniversary Collector's Edition of Blade Runner, the Steelbook of Heat, Austin Powers Triple Feature Blu-ray, Stanley Kubrick Triple Feature Blu-ray.
Okay. Like that. You didn't have to wish list the whole thing. It's not a computer. It would have been perfectly fine.
Transformers series, the Matrix leadership set, which is
my computer parts list is $1,500 for 16 items.
The only thing left, mine's $157.
For 440 items. $8,178.
Do you just have one big wish list?
No, I have. That's just for my main wish list. Let's see my DVD wish list. My DVD wish list, which is 203 items long, $3,490.
I do have a $290. DAC and DAC and amp combo. That's my biggest item on my wish list.
I can get all the books I want for $530.
Let's see how much my books cost. My books, which is $1,585 for all my books. It's only 93 items, by the way. Also, 93 items from the comics list is another $1,900. Good lord. I want to know. What's the value of my Lego list? Hold on. I gotta see this shit.
Oh, God.
$3,600. Not as bad as I thought it was gonna be.
Value of my electronics list, 8 items long, $1,924.
Alright, how about the video games list? $4,400, nice. Some items cannot be added to my cart. See. Oh, yeah, because those are not available currently. And I've got like $4,000 on board games on my board games list.
Who the heck is Annette Hare?
Huh?
Someone added me on Google Plus, and I don't know who they are.
I get people add me on Google Plus all the time.
Yeah.
That's like, bong, bong, who?
Just ignore it. Don't add it to your circles. They won't see anything you post. It's that simple. It's like, I love, that's one thing I love about, I think that Google Plus got right, was that I have to add you back for you to see my shit. I can just ignore the fact that you're following me. Anything I post publicly, you'll see. So my YouTube videos and things like that, you know. So it turns every person into a hybrid fan page / private account, you know. And you can still have a fan page. It's the only feature of Google Plus I like. The problem is Google Plus is still, you know, fucking terrible. They have the right idea for security and privacy, and not the right idea for like every other goddamn thing about it.
Alright.
I was gonna say, like, are we gonna start soon?
And then we walked away.
Okay, shall we begin?
Please.
Let's begin.
Let's begin.
Something I should mention, as you may have noticed, every season they have a new title sequence. Season 3, they actually had two. They had one specifically for this miniseries, and then one that they used for the regular episodes of the series, the season which followed. Now, in the Shout Factory set, they completely messed that up. And some of the episodes have the regular Season 3 title sequence. Others have the footage from the Five Faces of Darkness title sequence with the sound from the regular title sequence. There is no proper version of the title sequence on the Shout Factory set. Oh. And Brian Ward, the producer of the set, was asked about that. He said, yeah, when I was fixing all the other mistakes, I forgot that one.
Well, he was honest. I mean,
he forgot.
Even like...
That's really all the explanation there is. He just forgot.
He could have passed the buck on, but he didn't. He manned up and said, no, that was a mistake.
Which is funny, because on the G.I. Joe set, they fixed all the opening title sequences so they were season appropriate. But the one, like, significant Transformers one that uses a different title sequence, they forgot.
Oh, Matt wants to join. Sorry.
All right, Matt. Yeah, bring him in. Good. It's just in time.
And he just messaged me like, shit.
Now, that said, some of the streaming versions that some of you may be watching may have the correct title sequence. I don't know. I guess we'll find out.
It should be the same length regardless, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes. Yeah, it'll be the same. It's the same length of title sequence. They're always 30 seconds for the Transformers, but it's just annoying that they messed that up. Oh, well. So, waiting for Matt. I got discount bacon. There was bacon on sale yesterday at Save On. $4 off.
I had an amazing cheeseburger from the local burger place.
Hang on, I'm not finished talking about bacon yet.
Okay, continue the story of the bacon. I want to hear about the bacon.
I got two packs of the discount bacon. I put one in the freezer, one in the fridge. Basically, it was discounted so severely because it expired the next day, which is today. So I'm going to be eating a lot of bacon later.
Fucking A.
Because bacon. I don't buy bacon very often, but I love it.
Probably expensive as hell in Canada, eh?
It's like $7 or $8 a pack.
Actually, it's not too far from what it is here, too.
Really?
$7 a pack here.
So this particular one was $7.49 usually. $4 off, so I got them for less than half price.
Yay.
For less than the price of one. Yeah.
So that's pretty fuck good. Yeah, I love when they put sales like that on.
Hell yeah. So Justin, well, it's great.
Sorry.
Because, I mean, what's the bacon just going to collapse in a heap of mold the second it expires? No, that shit's loaded with preservatives. It'll be fine for at least a few more days.
And you freeze it, it'll be good for like a week.
Like months.
Yeah, what I usually do is I get it home, I open the package, I also get the clearance bacon, right? And I just put it in the Ziploc bags and throw it in the freezer.
Oh, so you have it like portioned?
Yeah, because I'm fat, but I'm not that fat. I'm not like, I'm not a whole package of bacon fat. I'm like a quarter of a pack of bacon.
See, that's actually a really good idea. I might do that next time.
And what I do also is before I put it in the bag, I cut it horizontally, so it's in two sets of smaller strips. Because then when you cook it, it goes on bread better. You don't have to break it up. It's like it cooks quicker because it's smaller pieces of meat.
That works.
Plus, it goes bread. So I cut it so it's two. Like the whole strip gets cut down the middle, and then I portion it out.
The thing for me though is I don't know what I'm gonna do with that bacon later. I may just want like strips of bacon.
Yeah, get smaller strips. But no,
it's not because I like the longer strips. It doesn't work for me. I understand the sandwich logic.
Fair enough. Man.
But
hey,
for like you know, no, fuck you, and you're cutting up the bacon idea.
It's your choice. You know,
how dare you? Fine, you want to wreck your bacon? Go right ahead, but.
Wreck yourself, or check yourself before you wreck yourself, son.
Check.
Hold on, I got something to show you guys.
What?
Let me go get it.
How? You're supposed to be prepared.
Matt will be here in a minute. He's just shoveling food into his gullet real quick. Like he's
something bacon related, I'm guessing. God damn it, Matt, you can eat on camera. The rest of us do.
All I was going to say about bacon is as long as it hasn't turned gray in the packaging,
yes, good. You don't want gray bacon or greenish gray.
Like, it'll be in the clearance section, but if it's gray, don't bother.
Don't fuck with it.
Pork should not be see-through. You notice that? When pork goes bad, it gets kind of translucent.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Weird.
You guys like bacon?
Yes.
Of course.
You guys like beef jerky?
Oh, a little bit. Yes.
Yeah, bacon jerky. Yeah. I've seen that.
Oscar Mayer decided to make bacon jerky.
Yeah, Roberto does it too, and so does Jack Lynx, but that's much harder to find.
God damn. I need to find me some of that.
You guys act like you've never seen that before. Eat that on a can like a month ago.
I haven't eaten it. Bacon. I've seen it. I don't know what you're talking about.
I've never seen it either.
You may have been eating it on cam, but did you show us? Did
yes!
You tell us what it was?
Oh my god, and you had the same fucking reaction. You guys are fucking forgetful.
Wow, Eric, thanks for showing that to us for the first time ever in our lives ever.
Yeah, my memory sucks.
Hurry up,
Matt. May you die in 1,000 fires of purgatory.
Hey.
Look at the bacon.
I will be in a story.
Right back. I just need to grab a real fucking one of these.
Why? Why do you need to be stapling right now? What?
You got paperwork to staple.
I just want to watch some Transformers.
You will watch some Transformers. Just calm. You can do it when you did.
I also want to get an early night. I've been working days and I'm fucking tired.
I understand, you know, Matt, when he gets here for taking forever, it's basically Matt's fault. Mild adjustments.
Where'd you message him? The cram ship?
No, he's not in part of cram ship.
God damn it.
He left cram ship because his message was his phone, so. Hey, it's Cash Black. Hi, Cash Black.
Hi, Cash Black.
What? Damn it.
How's it going, Cash Black?
God damn it.
Greetings, Cash Black.
Oh, shit.
Holy fucking shit. Can we watch our cartoons now?
No!
Apparently not. Fuck off, bus.
Don't worry, we'll get started eventually.
Tomorrow.
I love you tomorrow. Going to apply for jobs tomorrow. Oh, I also got an interview at a staffing firm.
Okay.
I totally thought it was EVGA emailing me, because the first thing it says is EVGA, show us your hard on.
Oh no! Oh no!
Show us your hard on case mod.
Uh huh.
What the fuck? There's a typo in the email. Show us your Hadron. Way to mistype fail.
Oh, baby, you really give me a Hadron.
Matt!
Cheers!
Finally! You know, Matt, you can eat on camera, you know. It's like drinking, it just involves chewing.
It's noisy!
We don't mind that all of us Sorry. Do it. So you wouldn't be singled out.
That was an emergency app, sorry. My cat got entangled.
That's okay. Matt finally decided to show up. So.
Oh, look, there's that. There's that furry shit. What's up, bro?
Cheers, Father Muckers.
Get yourself in the... cheers. Get yourself in the IRC so that you can get the links to the episodes.
Yes. I cheers you with bacon jerky.
I don't have a shot glass, so cheers.
Are we watching Hellraiser 7?
Yes.
No, and actually, we're watching American Ninja this week. So you have to show up, Matt.
I know. Actually, I had to cancel plans because I realized that I talked you motherfuckers out of watching the next Hellraiser episode, so I will be here tomorrow.
Awesome. Motherfucker.
I'll be leaving the next morning. So we're watching Transformers. Who the what the...
Transformers, Five Faces of Darkness.
The 95 Faces of Darkness.
The 95.
Episode what?
Season 3, episode 1 through 5.
Yes, or episodes 66 through 70.
Yeah, that's going to be easier to find.
Seasons 3 and 1, okay, I got it here.
1 through 5, yeah.
It's on Netflix.
Yeah.
They don't have the bumpers, so you'll have to pause at the commercial.
Yeah, the Netflix one isn't
really
complete.
Yeah.
I'll figure it out. I think we have a link in the chat.
We have a streaming link that someone found it, which we did not provide. That is all on our fans' shoulders.
Yes.
Don't blame us.
We're just, great to our fans like that. If anything should ever threaten us, it was them! It was them! They made me do it!
No, we can't be held responsible for what happened in the chat.
Yeah.
I can tell them no, but all I can do is kick them and they can come back. You know, there's no point in...
That's right.
There's no point in punishing people for doing what the fuck they're going to do. It's free. It's free over there.
I made my favorite stoner snack tonight, even though I'm not stoned. I haven't been stoned in like a decade.
Was that your dip?
No. That's my favorite food.
God damn it.
Regardless.
You need to make that for me.
Matt, now that you're getting married again, am I still able to come and visit you in the future?
I'm just going to show up at Metal's door. Metal, dip me.
No, I'm saying, now that you move on with your wife and you get married for the third time, am I still going to be able to visit? I mean, is that still going to be a possibility? I mean, I know it's kids then, because you got kids
what
now.
What the hell?
I'll have to coordinate it with her not being home and the kids not being home and nobody filming us.
You're not going to have a man cave room in which to escape from everyone
I'll definitely have a man cave.
All right, then.
Better.
I'm a bachelor, so my whole abode is a man cave, so I can't.
You need a can mave.
Can mave. All right, do you have the episode queued up now?
I got it on Netflix, so I'll just have to pause it whenever there's bumpers.
God damn it. All right, Eric, are you needing to know when commercials are too?
Yeah, I'm watching on the Flux of Nix.
What?
Netflix.
Okay, so that's a yes then. Okay, so we'll attempt to be alert and advise when there are commercials. Okay, finally, for the love of God, let's begin.
All right, I'm ready to roll. I just unpark my drive.
I am also ready to roll. I will also unpark my drive. Oh, wait a minute, mine doesn't park.
Yay.
I stopped that shit. I was like, no, I want things to happen now.
These are very old hard drives. Both these hard drives are actually 8 years old.
Wow.
So I put turn parking on to preserve them as long as possible.
Understandable.
I've got like 1 terabyte coming in the mail. So.
Cool. Let's watch cartoons. Here we go.
Yay!
Okay, part one of Five Faces of Darkness, the epic season premiere, third season premiere, following the just devastating events of the movie. Let's see what happens next. Three, two, one, play.
I've never seen this. I stopped watching.
Really? Yeah. Oh, my God. You missed out.
I stopped watching when the movie happened.
Oh, you missed out.
I started watching after the movie.
That was one of those kids that's like, you're going to kill Optimus Prime, you're going to lose me.
Like, fuck you. That's too bad, because I think a lot of people did, because it died after this. Mm-hmm. Which is too bad, because the third season, I think, has some of the best writing of the entire series.
Well, I agree.
Yeah.
Hooked on things.
Five Faces of Darkness.
There we go.
Nice.
Noises. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Now open!
I love how it picks up literally like right where the movie left off.
Sorry, I muted myself so I could like poke on that package. Yes.
Char.
What kind of char?
Yeah, its name is Planet. Keep in mind that Cybertron is in the same solar system as Earth.
Yes.
So they're not in the solar system currently.
Oh, he can only manage like half a transformation. Oh, there we go.
He just poops out an Neutron.
Yeah.
Now you got the center down for us, so we're gonna beat you up and take it.
Yeah, no kidding, eh? That's gratitude for you.
Yeah. If I were him, I would have eaten some before I left.
Oh, Menasor.
Oh, damn.
Damn, son.
Aggressive?
Be aggressive. Be aggressive.
Just keeps knocking them apart. Oh, the Insecticons, who apparently aren't dead. Somehow.
Well, the two of them are alive, anyway.
Yes.
Well, it looks like it's one and a half, because the other one's not even a fully formed Insecticon.
Mm-hmm.
God damn it, it's the biggest moth I've ever seen.
Mm-hmm. Astro Train just cannot get a break.
No.
Just want one cube.
As Matt goes and beats up a moth in the background.
Yeah.
Ow, demon spirit! Don't. How are you flying again?
What the
How are you flying?
What?
Is Matt pantsless?
I'd kill you with a broom!
What?
No.
I'd kill you!
He's wearing lounge pants.
Oh, it's him! I thought it was you stapling frantically over there, Steph.
No.
So he's killing a moth with his broom.
Oh, keep an eye out for not jazz here.
Well, make you break the sword out, you motherfucker.
Earth the droids. There. Shut
your
up.
Tentacles together.
Out.
There's Warpath.
As long as they're going, wowie zowie, our leader!
Optimus Prime!
The best, no. Better than Optimus Prime, Rodimus. Space Olympics. Arr, I hate you. Why couldn't you die in Jazz Levitz?
Cause there's Jazz. Yeah, go Jazz. Get him. Go get him, Jazz.
It's his brother, Jazz. Guy, right?
Jazz is awesome. I love Jazz. Check out Jazz doing Jazz things.
You done? I know you're jazzed about this, but are you done?
I'm very jazzed. Very jazzed about Jazz.
It's Wheelie who I want to just tear his head off and shove him up his ass.
Vermin says they all hit robot puberty as they have different voices. They don't all have different voices, just the ones that were big name stars in the movie.
Yeah.
John Machida is still Blur.
Scatman Crothers died, so, you know, kind of hard to...
What are you talking about? Jazz is right there. There's Jazz. Look at Jazz. It's Jazz. What?
Munka Spanka.
Munka Spanka?
Yep.
Munka Spanka?
There's all kinds of wrong.
Spanka. I guess better than Munka Spunka. Or Spunka Spankya.
Monkey Spunker?
Yes. Guessing they animated that around the same time that Scatman Crothers died. So they hastily changed the name to Munka Spanka. Thinking we wouldn't notice.
Could just call him Jazz.
Yeah, done with it. He didn't have any lines. whoa, brutal.
Right? Shoot the dead body over and over again?
Yeah.
Oh, there goes the corkscrew ship. Flying by really fast. See? There it goes.
And not spinning. Gee, those look like... Certain shark-like robots.
Oh, there's Carly.
It's like yeah. God, she got fat in the face.
Commercial. Awesome.
Trip to gun.
Right after these messages. We now return to the Trip Transformers. Gun. And we're back.
Yay! Really? It's not hurting him? Kind of
not at all, apparently.
I mean,
and they're all dead. Oh, Spike got blown up.
It's the make dad disappear bomb.
Yeah, wow, Spike, I see you're the same voice.
Yeah.
Cup is actually not the same voice, but sounds very close.
Yeah, yeah. He seems actually more gruff, than the movie.
A little bit, yeah.
Yeah.
For sure.
I think these are people I need to shoot. No. Yeah, now it is.
There we go.
Shit.
Everybody's dead.
That grenade just magically killed a bunch of fucking people.
Hmm. Gross.
Yeah. Well,
the hell?
Was that a Vulcan? Or not Vulcan? A Klingon attack cruiser?
No. Well then.
Meow.
Awesome. Hmm. Did I forget to post on Facebook? I did, didn't I? God damn it.
I
hope people seriously aren't relying on that. Like, that's just supposed to be a bonus thing.
Yeah.
They have no reason to not be here. It's their own fault.
Yeah, the fuck.
There's literally no reason to not just
leave you loved
the fucking
us.
Window open. You know? Especially when you know it's coming up. You're like, oh, in a few hours, I'm just going to open it so
well,
that we go live right here.
Yeah, exactly. It's not like it hasn't been posted on the schedule all week.
Yeah, I know.
Shut up!
There is no wind in space.
Where are they? Oh, they're in Unicron's head.
Unicron!
What do you know about wind? Fuck you. Solar winds, dick.
Hmm.
There's that song again.
Clank, clank. Clankety
clank. Clank, clank. Clanky, clanky, clank,
clank. Mm-hmm. He went that away.
I am not Leonard Nimoy. That's what we're looking for. The I am not Leonard Nimoy, a Tron.
So is it assumed that these characters are stronger than Optimus and Megatron were? The other Decepticons.
Why do you say that?
Well, because in the movie at the very beginning we see Devastator desperately trying to get into the base and just having a fucking load of trouble doing that, ripping into the side of it. Meanwhile, here in this scene, we see Rodimus literally hurl a Decepticon through the fucking body. You know?
Yeah.
It seems like he's
strong. You're losing me, style, man. Your logic's losing me.
Yeah,
okay,
Maurice.
Shush. Did you catch where that guy is from?
No.
The
no.
Socialist Republic of Carbomia.
Oh my god.
Oh my god, it's so racist.
And that's why Casey Kasem quit the show.
Wow.
That's so fucking racist. Socialist Republic of Carbomia.
Like, they mentioned it several times, and this is a recurring character.
Why did they think that was okay, even in the 80s?
Yeah, I know. Carbomia.
How did the fucking censors not catch that, either?
That's even more inappropriate today. Are you kidding me?
I know. It's inappropriate
then. It's the same thing as saying, I am from IED.
Do you have an IED? I have a statham to make.
Statement.
Yes. A statham. I will return to.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
What was the point of that? Holy crap.
That was the point. I like that little guy. I don't know who he is.
He threw a hat and exploded.
I know.
He's like a little Indiana Jones.
Sugar happy. Sugar happy. What the fuck? Brandon is paranoid. Are they coming to take you away, Brandon?
No, it's a weird chemical smell.
Oh.
I was seeing if there was like smoke outside, or if there was anything on the air, on the central air unit.
Oh, delicious. All roads lead to Char.
Who's with a Charmander?
You know what really pisses me off? Is that Perceptor is one of the ones that survived.
What? What have you got against Perceptor?
Perceptor's a pacifist. Of course he survived.
Okay, and also, Ratchet and Wheeljack are now dead. Who's going to fix everybody? They fucking need Perceptor.
Maybe if they hadn't killed Ratchet and Wheeljack.
I like Perceptor. He's the nerd.
But he's not just a nerd. His transformation is so useless.
No, it's not. He's a piece of lab equipment.
He's a scientist.
Commercial.
I know, Stoud. We all know. Oh, commercial.
He's not as cool as the other.
I know all about you and your fuck science crusade, but you know.
Fuck science.
And we're back.
And we're back.
You probably figured that one because, you know, cliffhanger and all that, but.
Cliffhanger!
I don't know how tight they've edited it in the version you're watching. I know in the Family Home Entertainment one, they would edit it really hyperactively. They'd actually cut the fades to commercial as well, not just the bumpers. Just
cut right to the next shot.
Yeah.
Oh, that would be brutal and annoying.
Yes. It was often very abrupt and jarring. At least the logic goes, we have to make it more movie-like and seamless.
Or you could have been smart and left commercials in for the toys.
Well, then you should see what they did with the three-parters. Like, they're cut into movies. But also with that hyperactive editing.
Yeah. I remember watching The Five Faces of Darkness a lot. I rented it quite often.
Yes. I think by the time they released this, they'd stopped doing that. So they still had it edited into a movie, but they kept the fades in at least.
I just remember watching this a lot.
Yes. I recorded it off TV in SP mode, and I watched my tape of it quite a bit.
We had this rental place right down the street from where I lived called Wizard Video, not related to the DVD label. And, yeah.
Nice.
I'd rent Transformers the movie, Transformers 5 Faces of Darkness, G.I. Joe the movie, and Godzilla 85 in, like, a rotation. Seriously.
Nice. That's a pretty awesome rotation.
Yep. My mom would be like, haven't you already seen this one? Yeah, like 20 times. Like, I didn't care.
I need to see it more.
Yeah. Occasionally I venture out and watch an anime, which is how I found Akira, you know. Some other stuff like Big Wars and Venus Wars. And later Ghost in the Shell, first movie.
Ghost in the Shell.
And Ninja Scroll.
Yeah. I used to have that on Laserdisc.
Anyways, it is time for Brandon to medicate.
Never saw Venus Wars. I see Disco Attack recently released it on DVD, though.
I really, really want it. It's one of my favorite anime.
I will have to check that out.
It's not the greatest anime. I just have really fond memories of it. And I've watched it as an adult. It's still pretty good. It's just I have an extra affinity for it. So.
Yes, I get it. There's a nostalgia factor.
Absolutely.
Yay!
Oh, his voice is so weird. Such a jarring transition. The voices.
That's Harry Mudigan, by the way. And he actually did the voice in the movie, too.
I thought Leonard Nimoy was voice in the movie.
Nope, that was Galvatron. That's Cyclonus. They're trying to save Galvatron.
Sorry.
You who have seen this 50 times.
I was not paying attention to the screen, bro.
Chill. Okay. Rodimus Prime used to go on a secret mission, so who does he bring with him? Grimlock.
Yeah. I know.
Meet Grimlock, be very quiet.
I think he brought Grimlock because Grimlock was the only one left.
Oh,
everybody else just.
Springer RC had to do something.
Yeah, Springer and RC just fucked off, and Ultra Magnus is kidnapped. And
fucked off, like I said that. Perceptions are passive. Yeah, like I said, Perceptor's
up. Way to be stealthy there, Grimlock.
Yeah, Perceptor's a capist. He's useless in kind of missions, you know. The Decepticons start shooting, and Perceptor's like, I'm putting my hands up.
I'm expecting them to start shooting.
I'm not the one that's been shooting at you. I can at most stare at you.
Oh, shit, we're at the end of the episode already.
Commercial!
Oh, that's quick. Yeah, I'm expecting them to start shooting and just all immediately fall over because they have no energy left.
Yeah.
Bang, 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 bang.
I do like the vocals for this version of the Transformers theme more than the previous one.
Justin, answer your question. Earlier about how Rodimus threw Galvatron through, check the chat with Remnart. He said, Unicron was already breaking up due to the power of the Matrix being partially opened, so it made it easier to throw him through the inside.
Oh, I see what you're talking about. Yeah. Because
he opened it, and Unicron had fucking shit coming out of him, and
it was pretty much
pants.
Galvatron was being thrown by the power of both Hot Rod and Optimus Prime at the same time.
Yes.
And Grayskull.
And the Sword of Omens.
Sight beyond sight, bitch.
I see.
And the power that comes from deep inside of you.
And my dad.
And
the powers of viewers like you.
And dare to keep all your
viewers like you.
Power in there with your coming.
Not you specifically, but viewers like you.
When I was little, I thought it was the name of a production company.
Viewers
like you, Inc.
Viewers like you.
Because
I've always watched public access. I always watch, fucking Bob Ross and Yonkin Cook and stuff like that on public access.
Oh, I remember Yonkin Cook. That was great.
I remember Bob Ross.
He was funny.
I remember.
There was also, did you ever see The Galloping Gourmet?
Yes.
Another one.
Yes.
Yeah.
Of course. And there's also Cooking with Ming.
Okay, I don't know that one.
He's actually still around. He does a show again on public access called Simply Ming.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
That's
still around. And also, I think the Yan Khan Cook guy is still around. He now tours Japan.
Is it? Oh really? I'm not surprised.
He tours Japan.
Matt Drew and Love and Care Bears.
He does street style cooking.
Street-style cooking with Jan. Okay.
Happy little trees.
But yeah, every time...
Happy field.
Grew up watching all that, and I never understood what it was, because they always said, in part, with viewers like you. And that was it.
Yes.
We make happy little photo. Pretty dressed. Don't you want to just go to that happy place, guys?
That right there is a guy that turned himself around after the war.
Yeah.
He was a bomber.
He didn't commit suicide, like everyone says. But died.
Yeah. Yeah. No, Mr. Rogers was never in a war, but Bob Ross was.
Yeah, that whole thing, like, oh, he was a Marine, so he has to wear, he wears to cover his tattoos, that thing. That,
yeah.
For Mr. Rogers.
Yeah, I remember all that. I actually believed it for a while, until I researched him and found out that, no. And there was a documentary on him, and he flat out said on national television that, no, he never participated in the war. That he got close to being drafted, but he never did.
Who, Janis Joplin?
No, Fred Rogers.
Oh.
Fred Rogers.
That was close.
But Bob Ross, on the other hand, served 20 years.
Yeah.
On my penis.
He was on a pension when he, while doing that show. Mm-hmm. That's why he did it for so cheap. He didn't need the money. He did it for the love.
For the love of painting and the
he
one
used the money to buy supplies, in fact, because that was
He served, well, according to the epic battle of history, he served, he dropped bombs over Guernica, apparently.
Where?
I believe that's in Vietnam.
No, I didn't hear what you said.
He said, thanks to the epic rat battle, they said he served 20 years and dropped bombs over Guernica. I believe that's Vietnam.
I don't know. I have no master of geology or geology or geography or geology for that matter.
Wow, you totally had a Trailer Park Boys rookie moment there.
I gotta take another two hits on him.
I know what jalapeno is. I want jalapeno.
Not except an opportunist. I'm an optometrist.
Ludacris.
Yeah.
Crisscross.
Crisscross. Wait, isn't half of Crisscross dead?
Ludacris Cross?
So it's just Chris or Cross?
I think it's just Cross.
It's Manilian Cross now.
Hmm. Now it's just horizontal line.
Berman says, I never wanted Bob Ross to say he was painting family garden paintings. I didn't want him to talk about my mum's bush. Wow. Tough room.
I was just a room was like honestly bad joke. I wish Bernard would have said that in person in the hangout. Oh.
In his British way of saying things Britishly.
I never wanted Paul Ross to say.
I mean, have you heard Bernard talk?
Well, everything's automatically funnier when you say it in a British accent.
I didn't want him to talk about
it. It either makes something funnier or makes you more evil. Depending
on there was a commercial about that on why most all evil people in movies or TV shows are British.
Well, look at all of the Empire. The Galactic Empire, except for Darth Vader, is British. a couple of random generals who always get killed. The non-British ones always get killed. You're not British enough
watching,
to be in Empire, you die.
They're disposable.
Watching Empire Strikes Back again. You know the whole joke about Lando Calrissian being the only black guy in the universe?
Yeah.
One of his bodyguards that walks out with him is black.
Oh, there you go.
But then
there you go. The only two women in the entire universe.
Yeah.
Well, there's the slave girls. Come on.
There's the dancers, female humans.
The stormtroopers.
Female humans. I see. Sorry.
Yes.
Okay, so shall we watch part two now? Is everybody ready on part two? Part two?
Yeah.
Yep.
Part two? All right, let's do it. Here we go.
Yay! Awesome.
Good.
You ready?
Yay!
Metal.
Yay!
Metal.
Yay!
Metal.
Yes, by the way.
Metal. Oh, that was you. I thought that was Stout for some reason.
No. Metal. Yay.
Why is it everything Metal's doing tonight, I think, is Stout doing it?
God damn it, Stout. Get out of this chat.
At which point he should hit the reset button and hang out. But then he won't be able to log back in, as we have proved time and again this week.
All right, here we go. Part two, Five Faces of Darkness.
Four left.
I need to stop eating fucking food. Let's do this.
Three,
two, one, play. And again, Shout Factory, thank you for the wrong title sequence on this episode, too.
I just realized something. Darth Vader was also played by a British guy in his physical form.
Who is?
David Prowse is British. Technically, all of the Empire is played by British people.
Well, there you go.
And one
thing I'm watching.
The Transformers. More than meets the eye.
Just such boss vocals in that one. Stupid scrapping slargs. It's like, whoosh, burp. Throw. The triumphant Autobots and Blur and Wheelie.
That's my laugh.
Yeah.
I can feel myself already getting buzzed, so I will be
What the hell happened to his voice
all
there?
All this stupid shit. He's doing a fuck motion with his arms.
That was a different voice actor. Die. Faceplant. Oh, I didn't realize they were on a fucking tower. That was just a nice safe cliff. Just in case you forgot everything that happened a few minutes ago. Damn. Yeah, I knew it. Damn.
Dong, ding, ding, bong, ding,
ding, dong, bong. Yeah. Oh.
Brother, yeah.
That's funny. All this time, I had no idea it was Harry Mudd doing his voice.
Really?
Yeah.
That's cool. I had no idea either, so.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Oh, I love that. I think I'm slightly ahead of you.
We're all getting sucked into the story now.
No, I'm just really, really feeling the effects of my medicine.
Ah, okay.
So I'm just like, whoa.
Can I say, though, like, again, already, we're seeing much higher quality writing than we saw in the previous season.
And animation, too, for the most part.
Yeah.
And yet nobody
like, some of Cup's lines there were awesome. Three kids and a dog could take the place.
No, my name's Teaspoon. I'm the chief dishwasher.
Yeah.
Yeah, those were like two great. I love the three kids and a dog line, though. That's my favorite. Yeah. You're just gonna have to stay alive. Mm. And kids are all cheering out right now, like, yeah, I don't know what we're gonna do, but yeah! Mm-hmm. Fuckers. Mm-hmm.
Commercial!
Do-do-do! Yeah.
Yeah. And we're back. So Rodimus came and lasted one episode and then died.
That was great, Grandma.
No!
In there somewhere.
Yeah. Doctor Who sound effect.
Hello, cicadas.
And cicadas, yeah. Another Doctor Who sound effect. 3% five. Math.
That's how my brain thinks about math.
This is the 2001 moment of Transformers.
The fuck?
Ah!
This is a weird fucking drug trip.
Oh, Spectre of Death.
Oh, dude, I love when it hits you and, like, your teeth are numb. and like your and bodies then you get really like, trippy
so you get Transformers like that.
No, I'm saying like you just I just get the waves of like wee.
Alright.
I'm gonna try to make my way to the bathroom. I'll be right back, Jim.
Thank you. Hey. Bozology.
Okay.
Okie dokie. Okie dokie.
Okie dokie.
Be great if they could do this on Blu-ray. Well, shit.
I remember this scene. Wait.
Like it was yesterday. Wait.
I feel a script retread right before my eyes. Hey, it's the sun from Watership Down.
Yeah, awesome.
He's that puddle.
Who disturbs my private shit? Yeah, thank you for delivering. Yeah.
Right in the neck.
Right in the cooch.
Hope he's not happy to see us too.
Galvatron's my favorite.
It looks like someone squeezed your balls before the last movie.
Hey, Ale, Acidophilus.
Commercial.
Ooh, Pop-Tarts sound really good right now. Not even hungry.
I think I might have some toasted English muffins with peanut butter and bacon.
I was just going to say, no,
I know what I can have. I have this meat and stick, meat and cheese stick things.
There you go.
Or summer sausage.
All right, take care of Vermin. Oh, he's gone. Never mind.
You fuck! And he's gone.
And you're confusing which character's lips are moving.
Guilty or innocent? Mm-hmm. Innocent. I'm sad there was never an official toy of the Quintessence.
Yeah, there was one. I don't think it was of the these guys. It was of the other Quintessence, the tentacle ones.
I'm gonna Google search because I'm curious as to what you were talking.
It's on TF Wiki.
Okay. There's a third party character or figure form. And then Energon had the Alpha Quintessence, which was some weird tentacle.
That's the one. It's the Alpha Quintessence.
Yeah, there was no official Quintessence toy.
We never had one of these guys with the rotating heads. Like, I thought it would have been a no-brainer to do a toy of them.
But like I said, there's a third-party company who made some. So yeah. Those are pretty cool. Yeah, they're really nicely detailed, too.
That's cool.
Stop with the laughing!
Yeah, it's not going to stop. It just dives into the lava.
Fuck this shit!
Right in the nose cone. It should be clear already at this point that Galvatron is fucking nuts. Yes. I'm gonna shoot you anyway. Blam. What are you trying to do? Create another Starscream? Like, come on. Let's fuel dissension in the ranks. Just because. Damn, that's a sexy pose. I love that. Whoa.
Wow.
Just dragging that one Quintesson guy around with them. He's become their beanbag chair. That's a fleet of one. Oh, silver bolt. Yay, aerial bots. Wow. Well, damn.
Well, fuck.
To be cunt in you'd.
To be cunt in you.
These episodes seem to be going by really fast.
It's very well-paced writing, that's why.
They are, yeah. Like, I always remembered the third season being more well-written, but I forgot just how much more well-written.
Yeah, it's really good.
Which makes it even sadder that it did not continue beyond this.
Fuckers.
Too bad.
Kill off your hero, see what happens!
I know what we should do at the end of Empire's
Steve Gerber. Steve Gerber was one of the story editors. That could have something to do with it.
He's the guy who made the Gerber baby food, right?
No. He's actually the guy who wrote the original Howard the Duck comics.
Oh, Steve Gerber. I didn't hear what you said, so I'm just saying. Yes. I'm hoping I get a clue.
Oh, okay. No, I just noticed that in the credits there, Steve Gerber was one of the story editors.
Yeah. I'm queued up on the next episode.
Well, I'm also queued up on the next episode.
Well, that's good for you. I'm not.
We're going to enjoy it.
Starting in? No.
It was like the tiniest little sliver, and it's going so fucking slow. Come on.
That's all right.
All right, I'm going to go pee real quick.
Yeah, take your time. It's okay. Oh, yeah.
Come on.
Oh, yeah. I'm so mad. I tore my shirt. Like, right here.
Fucker.
I went to, like, a pulled down again, and it kind of spread up my shoulders, and my finger went through it, and I was like, are you fucking kidding me?
What shirt is that?
It's my Macho Man Kool-Aid crossover. So, yeah. Oh, yeah! And it's, you know, has the glasses, and holy shit, I ran over things.
Bad.
No, rabbits
that time?
Okay. I'm not worried about it. I just wanted to get going as soon as possible. We have to wait for you. We have to wait. It's all right. Ain't no thing, son. Ain't no thing.
Why is it loading so goddamn slow?
Good God hates you.
It's doing what it was doing to Eric last night. I might have to just say fuck this and go to Netflix because it's just being.
Alright. I'm back. Everybody ready?
No! It's taking 5 billion years to load.
Cool. Yeah. You ready?
Yes, Sean, he's ready. Shut up.
Here. You want to see where it is? You see that little white spot there? That's how much it's
like. Hey, wait. Did you say white spot? You have white spot there?
Racist.
No. It's the name of a restaurant. The logo is a chicken. called the White Spot.
That sounds White so spot. Racist.
It's a family.
That was so Canadian and hurt.
The White Spot. I never actually thought of it that way, but it does sound kind of racist, doesn't it?
It's not like intentional, obviously. It's just funny.
This is like the 5 minute
part. And the logo is a chicken, so.
Look how much it has to load to get to the 5 minute mark.
See, I find the White Spot to be way less offensive than the Crazy Chicken.
The Crazy Chicken.
Or Pollo Loco.
I fucking love their food, though.
Oh, I do too. But, you what know, like, that's such a racist...
Is that as far as it's ever going to load, ever?
It's going slowly.
Cannery Row in Monterey, California is El Pollo Loco.
Maybe it's because there's
that
a whole...
place is, like, fucking amazing.
A whole six people trying to load it right now, and their servers can't handle it.
Probably.
Thank you, Nankyo. Nankyo says, awesome shirt. Have you seen the Cthulhu Kool-Aid Man crossover shirt?
Yeah, it's on mine. I showed it.
Cthulhu-aid. Thank you. I think my shirt is awesome, too. I like my shirt.
That nobody else has anywhere ever.
Anyway, I have not seen the Cthulhu crossover. I want that one.
What is your shirt, Brandon?
Oh, it's my Macho Man Kool-Aid shirt?
Oh, there we go. Oh, cool.
Oh, yeah!
Yeah, unfortunately, I ripped it today.
Oh, no.
I'm trying to, like, adjust, because you kind of know what I mean. I'm getting fat.
Okay, that was totally unintentional. Like, oh, yeah! Oh, no. Yeah.
Of course.
That sucks. That's
exactly what happened. It ripped and went... Oh no! I just started laughing to myself because I didn't know. I was like, "Wow!" I just slayed myself. It's great.
Yeah, I had a Roger Rabbit shirt from 1988. Uh-huh. Really nice big picture Roger on there, bright colors, beautiful condition, and somehow a big hole formed in the armpit.
Yeah, I'm just so. I ripped it though.
I think mine was ripped too. Actually, it was just.
Show up, but I mean, literally, I just went like this, and this whole hole, my hand reached my shirt, and then pulled down before I realized what was happening. I was like, "What the fuck?" No!
So you basically made it worse.
Yeah.
Intentionally, yeah. Sucks.
Yeah, this is from T Fury Nikio. So I'm aware. Appreciate it though. I appreciate it.
It's loading a lot faster now, so it looks like we'll be able to start soon.
Okay.
Cool.
That's so fucking awesome, Stab.
Good.
I'm going to grab a Pop-Tart, since someone mentioned Pop-Tart.
I'm going to go make some bacon. No, that's good. I'll do that later.
Bacon. As you know, everybody loves bacon.
I don't know what to fucking put here.
Oh, there we go.
I don't know.
Oh my god, why Weird Al did you get stuck in my head?
Which one?
Don't you girls want something like me? Fuck, what the fuck? I had the beat in my head, and it's the fucking beat that's in my head. And if I try to, like, describe it, you'll be like, I don't know what the fuck you're doing. I know.
Okay.
So I'm just going to be like, it's a song that Weird Al parried during one of his polka videos, and now the beat's in my brain.
Oh.
Yeah.
So you ready?
Yeah, ready.
Alright. Let's do this. Part 3 of the 5 Faces of the Darkness, on the Transformers,
also known as The Transformers, the movie 2.
Sure.
Whatever you say, Brandon.
Yeah. just like whatever that other thing was the other day. I forget what it was now. I think it was on Saturday Night Insanity. All right, let's do this.
Woo.
Everybody ready? Is everybody there?
Yeah, man.
Stoud, stop burping.
God damn it, Stoud.
All right, here we go.
Burping all the time.
3, 2.
Some fucking people.
Play. Oh, there we go. If you're watching the Show Factory version, this is the correct footage for the opening of Five Faces of Darkness. But it's the music from the other opening. It's the same song, but the sound effects are all from the wrong opening. So the Sharkticon just made a driving sound as it came towards the camera.
Nice.
Explosions towns where there's no explosions.
Yeah.
Clank, clank, dink, clank, bonk.
It's just like two guys in a room banging pipes and garbage cans together.
Pretty much, yeah.
It had one hell of a high. Even though they escaped like 5 minutes prior.
Flint delay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Run away! Where's Gay Galvatron when you need him? You still think he watches us?
Gay Galvatron!
Stars on Mars. Oh, Sal, you've never seen Transformers the movie, right?
What?
Hmm.
Yes, I have.
Oh, darn.
Yeah, my brother showed it to me years ago.
Oh, yeah, we get to watch Paranormal Activity tonight, don't we?
God.
Five what? Splot.
Commercial.
Trypticon. So I used to do as a kid, sing the song with their names.
We now return. And we're back.
Yay.
What? Who, what?
They're following still, oddly enough.
A Seward.
Wow, my face. Jesus.
I reckon.
Well, damn.
Fuck you!
Suck a dick!
Hmm.
The storm is imploding. Skeleton Fear. Hi, Skeleton. For Latin, sorry.
I feel they have to deliberate over whether or not to chuckle.
Let's chuckle.
She said.
We're in the middle of episode 3, Krelitan.
Yes.
The Latin. Whatever, drop. Everything can be worse. You could also be on fire.
Some kind of genital system.
Oh my God, my head's so heavy right now.
What is?
My head is, it's a very heavy head to have on my head right now. What does it matter? It matters not. I am Gay Galvatron. You can also just avoid it. Maybe I can do nothing of use. Oh, Springer. Can I get an orange one, please? Thank you.
No! Commercial. And Springer gets... And Springer gets mulched.
Captain Ultra Magnus Springer. We're back.
We're back.
We'd be like this.
Yeah.
God. Another Autobot down. to the hunger. I have it so bad. Yeah. I'm driving you mad. Is.
Oh, God.
Sean, are you doing YouTube comments right now?
No, I'm not. I'm reporting that fucking eBay listing.
I was going to say, Sean, I had no idea that you were selling your entire DVD collection on eBay. Uh-huh.
Actually, there...
Did the guy respond with fuck you or something?
No. It just doesn't seem an easy way to report it, so I'm basically threatening him.
Oh, Lord.
Basically saying, the fucking picture down, or you're being reported to eBay's copyright infringement department. Thank you.
Sean, I found the report page.
Yeah, I found the report page. A category for this specific issue.
Oh.
I searched through all the subcategories. It's a blatant violation of their policy, but they don't have a specific category for it in their report page.
Oh, here we go. No, never mind.
Trust me, I've looked. There's only one way to do it, and it's very complicated, so I'm just going to try to get him to take it down. The only way to do it is to send a complaint in writing to the eBay's copyright department.
Who's gay?
Mm-hmm.
So far, he's the only Decepticon he's been nice to so far.
Mm-hmm.
The Jovian moon, Io, which is Io, I'm pretty sure.
I never heard it pronounced Io, ever, except by you, just now.
Okay.
Just need the dick stamp. Dick.
Oh. Hey, there was like a weirdly colored shockwave there.
I noticed that.
Yeah.
I wonder if it's
color on screen to be continued this time.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Wait, is that the only... They had that each time. I don't know.
Really? Not on the Shout Factory version.
Yeah, not on here. This is actually the first time, yeah.
Weird.
Yeah, I think the Netflix ones are the Shout Factory releases.
Really?
Because
for whatever
the
reason they cut the bumpers?
Yeah, because the intro changed after the third episode.
Oh, so it was, oh, so you have been seeing the same intros I have?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
You're saying this is where it changed and it's different than ours with the same music.
Yes, so the footage you saw, that's what the intro is supposed to be for all five parts of this.
Oh, yeah, the last one was like... almost just like scenes from the movie.
Yeah. Well, the first one, like the one we saw in the first two parts, that's the regular intro for the rest of the season.
Okay, yeah, because it shows like Unicron being destroyed and the head flying around.
Yeah, it has a whole bunch of different stuff. Some of which actually relates to this miniseries, which is why...
Yeah, it fit in pretty well for the first episode, but it felt a bit redundant in the second one.
Yeah.
What a surprise! It's not loading.
Awesome.
Not loading.
Come on, Gorilla Bid. Come on.
Transformers.
Transmorphers.
Oh, God. I've avoided both Transmorphers films. I don't know if I can for long. I do movie gangbang after all. Eventually, I'm going to run into that.
Transmorphers.
The good news is, Sharknado 2 will probably happen way before then. And then we can hear 20 minutes into Sharknado 2. Breaking the previous record of Sharknado 1, Matt fell asleep and snored through the whole movie. You did!
Here's the next part, I gotta go to the bathroom.
Awesome. The beautiful soothing sounds of metal snoozing.
You snooze like no other, sir.
Sharknado's like one of our most popular episodes, too.
That's just because it's a fucking horrible thing that everybody wants to research.
Research?
Yeah.
What causes this horribleness?
I'm working on my my thesis, and I must do more research on
it. My thesis of bullshit.
Speaking of theses of bullshit, I've got to get a roll eight because I got a hot bun, then I'm going to come back and I'm going to do a shot, then I'm going to kill a young child. That was
my favorite part is that last part. Too many young children. Let's make that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Burn the witch.
Crinkle, crinkle, you say?
Crinkle, crinkle. Star. Yeah, we're not watching the show right now. It's alright. God damn it. Texas went bad.
Texas? All of Texas went bad?
I think my pretzel's going to bad shit.
Is that even possible?
Yeah. It's when they taste weird.
Stale?
No, stales they
stale?
Can't.
Stale?
No. Stale doesn't change the flavor. They just get really hard when they're stale.
Or if they're potato chips, they get really stale. Rubbery.
Right. In this case, though, I've had these for, like, weeks. And the last couple nights, I've not closed the bag properly, I think.
Oh, that's probably why.
So they've gone from stale to worse.
So stale to, like, humid stale.
So, like, what the fuck did I just eat? I gotta go grab something else to eat to fix my tongue.
Yeah.
It feels weird.
Really?
Sharknado movies in disguise.
Movies.
Almost wage their battle to destroy the evil forces of Marvel movies.
Plots and such.
Plots.
Sharknado weather in disguise.
What?
Sharknado. All right, who's doing a shot? Let's get it.
I have nothing.
I'm new shot.
What the hell?
And it was at that moment we lost him.
I'm doing a shot.
I had to sit down.
I do a shot.
Got it. It's my...
You go right ahead there, and you do that shot. You do it good.
You do that shot, man.
So I just found out my cousin got laid off from the shop. After going on a week-long vacation, he comes back, and the next day he got laid off.
What does he do?
No, he's a security tech. He's a computer security expert.
Uh-huh.
He's a hacker for the good guys.
Yeah,
he's a hacker for the good guys.
Awesome. How's the loading going there, Stoud?
Good question. It is, holy shit, fully loaded.
Awesome! All right, I'm ready to go. Let's do this. I got not stale pretzels.
Are we doing this?
Sean, yes. We are ready.
Hold on a second, Jesus.
Okay.
Right up, man. Sean. Hurry up, Sean.
We want to make sure you heard us. That's all.
Christ, fucking sakes.
Christ. Yeah, I don't know.
Christ.
Fucking shit, motherfucking cock fuck.
Stout, I come to the conclusion that you're slowly drifting off camera.
I have no idea what you mean.
We're looking at your fucking shoulder, and it's gone! It's gone!
It's now the...
Like, seriously, you need to be on the other side of your mic, bro. That's where your camera is.
I was gonna say, the longest time there, it's been the... Especially when it's on the smaller camera, it was the Stoud Shoulder Show.
Yeah.
Sweet. I'll point it directly at my face.
Maybe you should move some shit.
I have no room.
Or,
here's a hint. Why don't you put it on top of your fucking monitor?
You know,
like a normal person.
Ladies and gentlemen!
On top of my fucking dick, look.
Look at my camera. Mine's on top of
me. Are you trying to be do a impression of him? Because...
My show, goddammit. You're gonna stare at my shoulder? You're gonna stare at my shoulder.
Like, this is something. I love being in the dark because I can do something like
that. Got an Ewok on the side of your.
It's a zombie. Walking dead zombie.
AKA, it's a generic zombie. They decided to say it's from The Walking Dead.
You shut your worm
not
out.
Really. It's the bicycle lady. See? She
yeah.
So, thanks. Just has
super
spine.
Zombie. Shouldn't like the most... first zombie. Well, the one you, first one you see on screen. Like in like horrible, ridiculously awesome detail.
I have some time to actually clean things up because then I'll be able to move things around so that this won't be a problem.
Or you can just put it on top of your monitor. Like a normal
it
person.
It looks stupid on top of my monitor.
Who gives a shit? No one sees your computer but you.
Penis!
No, I mean that I look stupid in my camera when it's from that angle.
What?
I don't like it. I don't like it. I don't
and
like
you
it.
Don't look stupid now.
That's right. I look fucking fantastic.
Yeah, that's a self-image issue, sir.
Oh my god, shut up! I'm not putting it on my fucking... Oh my god.
On top of your monitor, get the fuck out.
Fuck you, Stoud.
Oh, God. I do look at the other monitor, though, even though we're live, because my video is over here. And the Hangout's over here with the camera.
Alright, there we go.
Seriously, there we go. Thank you.
What?
Can we go now?
Wait,
we
just chill the fuck out. I was submitting my contract infringement report. And my pictures taken off of those fucking eBay listings. Thank
you. So there's multiple listings now?
There's two. Yeah, both using the same picture. So, all right, let's do this here. Part four, ready to rock and roll.
See,
finished a decent hour tonight.
If I do any eBay auctions, I'm going to use it too, but I'm going to ask for permission first. That's
yes.
The difference.
And then I will say no. All right, let's do this. 3, 2, 1, play.
We'll see. And now we're back to the other intro. What the fuck?
Yeah, that's the other intro. I think we got the proper intro on the last part. But, again, with the wrong sound.
Yeah, now something like Saturn's rings.
Yeah.
It shows... Yeah.
Well, yeah, I mean, this is the normal Season 3 intro. It's just not supposed to be on the main
series.
I only
got one episode.
Yeah. Because Brian Ward forgot. Yes, you just didn't think this story was that important. I don't know.
It's only the 5-part series that links the movie to the fucking series.
I know. And the only 5-part story of the entire series.
You know what's down out of the corner of my eye that was creepy? Because I didn't see your hand, I just saw something move. Google.
Springer bits.
Now part of a nice balanced breakfast.
There, is that better for you?
What's going on?
Now it's not Stout Shoulder.
Oh, there we go.
Stout Shoulder Show.
Finally, after weeks and weeks and weeks, the face of Stout.
It's the first appearance of Stout's face, right? Ever.
Galatin says, pestering Stout is the funniest thing I've heard all week.
Well, I'm glad it brings somebody some joy.
It's just normal operating procedure for the rest of us. We all gang up on one guy and on something ridiculous, like where your webcam's placed.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes we take it too far. It
all those generic Decepticons in the background. One of them colored like Rodimus with Grimlock's tail. What the hell?
And one looks like Warpath and Springer.
But awesome.
Nice one, Scott. Nice.
Did Galvatron just fly out of Galvatron's robot form?
Oh,
maybe. He did, okay.
So what, maybe?
He just shot Cyclonus in the face for no reason. And he's shooting his own guys. Totally not his voice. That's his voice.
Hail Hitler!
Mm-hmm. Yeah, pretty much.
How are they getting out of the goo?
Mm-hmm.
Ways.
Oh.
We're going to die.
Friendly personalized service with good payment terms.
Remove even the toughest stains.
Kill the Grand Poobah.
If I were to own any Transformer toys, which sadly I don't, I want a Wreck-Gar.
A Wreck-Gar, eh?
Yeah, there's a Generations toy and an old toy. The Generation toy looks really good, though.
I would love one that talks. That would be fucking fantastic.
Actually,
I like a talking red card.
Actually, own a random TV cards. I own a second red card because I was going to replace his head with a third-party kit that turned him into a different junkie gun, so it had more than one.
Ah.
That's the first time I've ever heard him denote a sex to William.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What do you mean?
You said her, talking about William.
Oh, really?
Before that, there was no sex to denote it at all.
Just come back.
Yeah, we're back, sorry.
So Wheelie's a girl?
Yeah, he just said it. That's what Blur said.
I always thought it was... Okay, but Grimlock called him a boy.
Yes, so Grimlock's not exactly the sharpest tool in the shed.
Well, yeah, but I mean, he looks like a little boy with, like, a baseball cap.
But he said her.
I don't know. You sure he was talking about Wheelie?
And not her?
And not Marissa?
Honestly, I don't know now. He did say her, though, and the word Wheelie.
Okay.
So,
maybe Wheelie, we have to get her.
Oh, maybe.
Meaning Marissa. I don't know. Well, the ship is toast.
Man, they have no luck with ships, do they?
Yeah, they have terrible luck with ships.
You're going to panic productively. I like that.
I believe that is the genesis of panic, though.
Yeah, I know.
Panic more calmly!
Panic with purpose!
Decepticons deceive.
Oh!
Ow! I'm the one cooperating.
It's like a giant colon. That just makes me more angry and insane! Zingu.
Oh, Lord.
Ah.
It got in my mouth. Oh, God, it got in my mouth. It tastes so bad.
I will not be defeated by a garbage scum. Ejected, and with another Doctor Who sound effect, by the way.
Oh. I assume these sound effects are in, like, some sort of large collection or something.
Mm.
And that's why they got originally used, right? I mean...
Like, what?
I'm sure, like, the Doctor Who and Star Wars sounds are because they're part of, like, some sort of archive.
No.
No?
Well, they are now, but they were originally created for those programs.
Oh.
Like the Star Wars effects, they're all original.
Then they were just stealing sound effects then.
Yes, they absolutely were.
Huh.
Yeah. And they, they might have licensed them, but I noticed all the Doctor Who sound effects are all taken specifically from a sound effects album that I have. Like every single one of them has been is also on that album.
Interesting.
Yeah. Almost expect to hear the TARDIS sound at some point. Like they've taken so many of the others.
Hmm.
They probably licensed it. I don't know about the Star Wars ones, though. Hmm.
What the fuck? So, I do goodbye to this cherry airhead. It's like fucking Play-Doh.
Delicious. And you've eaten a lot of Play-Doh, have you?
In my time, yeah.
There was two weird shaped shockwaves there. Two.
Shockwave don't die. He
I say weird shaped, I meant weird colored. Hey, they rebuild Ultra Magnus. Why not Springer, too?
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Look after you're fucking my girl. I mean, what? He doesn't answer.
Uh-huh.
Really a different looking Matrix.
So basically, kills himself so he can get into the Matrix. Oh, commercial!
Winnebago! Oh,
fucking hell.
Suicide! Kids love it!
Kids.
We're back.
Giant shovel.
Yeah.
Robots.
Robots. Cirque du Soleil. Krillin just had an epiphany and says, "Oh my god, it all makes sense now."
Deadly danger.
That's a pretty heavy chunk of Transformers lore right there.
Yeah. Danger. Deadly danger.
And Matt, asleep in his chair, totally missed it.
Awesome. Is he asleep?
Man, I missed it all because I was asleep in the chair.
You all suck.
Huh? What? What happened? What did I miss?
I was just like...
Have we started watching yet?
I literally, as soon as he committed suicide, is when I blacked out and came back.
I thought we were all just kidding. Quiet reference.
I was just sitting quietly like, wow, this is...
I was just gone. I conked out for a minute.
Wow.
I know.
Oh, shit.
I'll watch it again later if I care. I mean, I've seen it. I just don't remember it.
Well, yeah. Oh, shit.
Oh, yeah. I forgot about this part. Oh,
Christ.
The one toy I always wanted and never got.
Trypticon.
Yeah. Rower.
Trypticon and Springer are the only toys I never got that I really wanted when I was a kid. When it comes to Transformers.
Yeah, I'd like to have a Springer, to be honest.
I wanted Rio Blast for He-Man, but no, I got that.
Oh, look, it's Cosmos. Just standing there staring. Useless as always.
The midget he is, yeah.
Hi, Boba Fett.
Who is it? Who's landing? Anybody we know? He just flew by.
Oops.
Oh, shit. It was a suicide bomber.
From Carbomb?
Oh, damn. From Carbomb, yeah, that's right.
Or bum ya.
Gotta bum ya. Damn.
To be continued.
To be continued. Bang, 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 bang.
Bang. Is this the last episode of this
there two-part episode? There is one more. One more. That was part 4 of 5.
What kind of dance move was that?
It's awkward is what it is.
It's called
Saturday Morning Incorporated. So Flint Dilley, Steve Gerber, and Marv Wolfman were the story editors. Marv Wolfman from Marvel.
Yep.
That's pretty cool.
The Marvel, yeah.
The Marvel, yes.
Wonder Man.
Marvel.
Wait a minute. Are you trying to tell me this is a Marvel production?
What? Yes, it is.
No.
You didn't know that?
It's Sunbow, but Marvel?
Yeah. The image. G.I. Joe.
Oh, now you're going to tell me G.I. Joe is a Marvel thing, too.
Yep. Yeah.
G.I. Joe was a toy line, Sean.
Completely unlike Transformers, which is an original science fiction series.
Yep.
That no other things associated with it at all.
Right.
Prolatin's mind is being blown. He says, glad I haven't seen most of this season. Love having it a surprise. Oh, absolutely.
Jamie's coming.
It's a good stop.
What's coming?
Jamie's coming.
Jamie's here.
Thought she was only breathing heavy.
No. Jamie's coming to the hangout more than likely. She hasn't
finished yet. She's here right now. Look.
I thought Jamie
was done. What are you talking about? No.
Not in the hangout.
Oh. How many times does he have to say in the hangout?
I'm the stoned one. Jesus.
Are you sure?
Fuck everything. Fuck everyone.
He totally went to go pee. Fuck everyone.
Poor Stout.
Hi, Jamie.
Hi.
He's gonna message me from the shitter. Fuck those guys. Fucking assholes.
That was like one of the best storming out of the rooms we've had in a while. It's awesome. Oh, here we go.
What the hell was that, Sean?
Well, I just had to wait for the girls to get here, you know.
Oh.
Crank up the sexy. Yeah.
It's all sexy now.
I know. We're a bunch of sexy guys. With our potential pork chops and farting. And cartoons.
Farting and a burping. And a munching and a
I'm a man, listen to me fart. And you just hear.
I have a great public washroom at work story, but I'm going to save it for Saturday Night Insanity, so you just have to wait.
So look forward to that, folks.
There was a good one this week. It didn't involve me, but I was there. I heard it all.
I don't know, was it anything better than Cass making everyone in a tire shop laugh?
Okay, well, if Cass is there this weekend, we got to get him to tell that story.
Yeah.
It's only on Facebook right now.
That was brilliant.
That was pretty funny.
That's your sneak preview, by the way.
Yes, you'll have to wait to hear the rest.
Maybe.
Public washroom stories. We know you love them.
God. What is it, like, volume 4?
Yeah, oh, God. Me like, have the epic ones.
Maybe you know? Volume 40. One of these days I will go through all the Saturday Night Insanities, and that is one series of stories I will be extracting and giving its own spin-off series of compilations.
So it'll be the Cass's washroom stories, and it'll be everyone else's poop stories.
Yes. Oh my God, Cass's like washroom and poop stories are just epic. They're always hilarious.
They really are. That man is just as accident prone in bathrooms as I am. And or he just finds himself in the most embarrassing situations.
I love that night where you both told your respective shitting in a bucket stories.
Yes! Oh my God. Yeah, both
of Jamie over here.
I was just done that night. Like, I could not stop laughing.
Well, really gotta edit that. That's got that one night needs to have its own clip. It really does. Yes.
Oh, it will. It will. One of these days. You need to find the time to sit down and watch all of them and then extract the clip from it.
As soon as I get everything moved over to the new computer, I'm going to start downloading a movie Gangbang and see if I can make some clips out of them, you know?
Oh, okay. There you go.
I just don't have the space right now. I mean, I have a terabyte.
But it's a big time commitment when every episode is like 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 hours long.
Well, we had that 1 8-hour episode in the New Year's episode.
Well, there was the one where I was building shelves. It was a 7-hour episode.
Oh, God. I was just simply talking. Yeah, that was the episode when I was simply talking.
Is that
talking
what you're
about,
talking about? Yeah.
I was talking about maybe movie Gangbang. Yeah, same thing. Just as ridiculous, you know. We both had our 8-hour episodes.
Yeah. There will probably never be clips of these live viewings because it's just way too much stuff to go through.
So if you do take the time to find your favorite clips and you give the and you know get us the files, we will credit you for doing the work that you do. That is fair.
Or just like, or just give us the time markers where your favorite segments are.
Oh yeah.
Then
if you want to do that.
Them. Yeah.
If someone wants to do it for me, I'm okay with that too. I'll give you credit. Like, oh yeah. Dean found this clip. You know.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Exactly. All right, we all get to go with the epic final part here. Maybe.
I need to get a chaser. Give me a minute and 47 seconds.
Oh, God.
47 seconds, man! I just asked for a minute and 47 seconds.
Just go. Go, Matt. Go.
I gave him my first four child.
Go. The first grandchild, is that what he said? Oh, shit.
Oh.
I was really hoping to get this done in 2.5 hours. We're almost hitting the 3-hour mark now. Actually, we're not, because we went live later, so...
Yeah.
Never mind.
You're at the 2.5-hour mark, aren't you?
Besides which, it's your own fault.
Actually, yeah, it's not too bad. So I think, like, the actual live portion, we're at the 2.5-hour mark. And then another 30 minutes, and we'll be done. Awesome. Yeah, I forgot how good this miniseries is. It's been a while since I've watched it. Like this really I liked the call back to Orion Pax Wardon there. I thought that was a nice touch. Like you're really starting to get a build up of the backstory and the lore now, which is great.
Click message, thank you.
I went shopping today and I did not have the foresight to pick up alcohol.
Oh.
Shame on me.
I thought you were going to say, I went shopping today and I did not have the foresight to bring money.
Oh, no, that's miserable. I hate when I do that. I have
well,
all
luckily, I went to Giant Eagle, which also has my bank in it. So
well, 2:45. Perlatin says it's 2 hours 45 minutes.
There we go.
We started a little later. A little earlier today.
And of course, 12 minutes later, Matt shows back up.
Yes.
There he is. Okay, we good to go? We ready?
Ready to rock?
Let's do this. Let's go. You ready? We're going now. He's staring at it over there. What's so fascinating on your wall?
Porn.
Mine? It is. It's porn. I went downstairs. I'd left the TV on Vivid.
Oh, okay.
What they're showing right now is 1920s vintage porn.
Oh, sweet.
That's fucking... I was like... I
go,
was,
Granny, go.
I could probably show this on YouTube. No, I'd be fired. Okay.
Is it called "Went Back When Grandma Was Hot"?
It's
called "All."
I've seen some of that vintage stuff, like silent movie porn and stuff. It's really weird.
That's what.
See, now
is.
I just I feel totally inappropriately dressed at this moment.
See that. That's sort of been a mainstay of, like, man's journey through the world of photography. Every time we develop a new form of photography, one of the first things people do is film themselves having sex with it.
Not in photography. Anytime we find art, painting, we painted some naked chicks. I mean...
Well, yeah, that's true. Yeah, any kind of visual art. We just want to see people doing it all the time.
I bet you some of the first writings were fucking porn. I bet you it was a rocka.
Well, the Marquis de Sade, that was his big claim to fame. He was one of the first.
I wouldn't be surprised at all.
He was one of the first, like, big erotic fiction writers, and he was considered very cutting edge at the time. He's also considered insane, but that's beside the point.
He also had a lot of kink that was a little...
And now we have cross-species porn books. Yay!
Did you ever see Quills with Jeffrey Rush?
I have not.
Quills is really good.
I totally remember any books about women fucking.
I used to own that.
Yeah, so did I. I had
the DVD.
It's basically the story of the Marquis de Sade, and Jeffrey Rush plays him. Super.
Have you ever seen the puppet porno of the Marquis de Sade?
No.
It's disturbing.
Sounds like it. Well, speaking of the Marquis de Sade. Assad and classic silent porn. Shall we watch the last episode of Transformers?
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Like the intro to a movie gangbang.
Yeah. Alrighty, let's do this.
Okay.
Here we go. Part 5.
Epic conclusion. Fucking on my TV right now.
5 Faces of Darkness. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, play. Pile on! The hell?
On a Jovian moon. I still haven't got this cough frog out of my throat.
Yeah, see, all the clips in that intro are from the miniseries.
Thank God for Marissa.
Yay, Marissa Fairborn. Mm. Or we'll just all get blown up. Looks like some miscolored cyclonus is there. Weird.
One of the other colored swoops, obviously.
Paraglide! Hey, there's the Ark. The Ark is still there.
It's a different gears. Sorry.
Kinda, yeah.
Bam! Fuck that guy. God. Why could he die? So let Ironhide instead.
Hey, Beachcomber's still alive. Yay!
Oh, you didn't want to end up with a boom or a powie or a wowie or something? Love the toy. Hate the fucking ticks.
That's a monster been born that we can't transform.
God damn it. First appearance of Skylinks and the Predacons.
This space shuttle with nothing attachments, nuts.
Yeah. He's a space shuttle bird dinosaur guy who's really well spoken.
Space shuttle Concord mix?
Kinda, yeah. Oh no.
Zintai.
Bless you. Oh shit. Oh shit. Well, he just did.
It's totally a fuck your couch.
Yeah, really.
Right in the face. Right in the hoods. Oh.
Jeez.
Just chucking them all. Just tossing them all like they're toys.
Wait a minute.
Oh, no. Holy shit!
Mm-hmm. God, it's like a friggin' Zoid.
Yeah, he is. He's very much like a Zoid.
Like Gojulas, you mean, specifically?
Yeah. I don't know any of the Zoid names.
That's the Godzilla-looking one.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, Gojulas, or... Yeah. Let's stick with Gojulas.
Gojulas is the one I remember.
Yeah.
I have him somewhere in the basement. The only one I ever bought because of the fan.
Commercial!
Commercial! Yeah, yeah.
Bam!
Bowie!
Wow! Zowie!
Zaya!
Boom!
Oh, God.
Zang!
We back?
Oh, yeah, we're back. Sorry.
Jesus Christ,
yeah.
Man.
Sorry, I got caught up in the impression.
I was a little there for a moment.
Sorry.
Oh, Durs, you're still useless. Or Durs did just explode into 1,000 pieces.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
You can tell something's a bit fucked up about him.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Holy, where's the typing coming from? Stoud.
What? Actually, it's from Jamie.
Oh, it's Jamie. Never mind. Stab just gets blamed for everything.
Fuck you, Stab.
What? I watched the show. Fuck up. Uh
huh. Eh. Pinball.
As you command. By your command. Holy shit, Jamie. It sounds like swarms of cockroaches. The down position. The down position. Say single switch. The deactivate everyone switch. Hmm. Awesome. Spherical flaming things. Predacons are pretty cool. Well, that doesn't rhyme.
Right in the face.
Uh-huh.
Oh, Jesus.
I like how the bottom part turns into this
awesome
boxy lion thing.
Now that I've done punting you, I'm just going to blow you away.
Power pose there.
Look at all the cool things you can do with these toys, kids.
No kidding. Eh? Demonstrating all of the cool things, Predacons and Skylinks.
Oh, what's this thing I tripped over?
Yeah. Mile, the story would be different is, yeah, we lost the cog. No idea where it went. Just, I don't know.
This is Bastard, I mean Blaster.
Mm-hmm. Shaboopy? Commercial. And we're back. There.
Thanks for the narrator.
I kept it tight this time. I hope that kind of makes up for last time.
Yeah, because I was only on for like 7 seconds.
Okay, good. You're just like, are we back? Oh, yeah, we were back like a minute ago. Damn it! Inspecticons! Now the cog actually looks like a cog.
Babylon!
Now it looks like what it looked like before.
They're playing football.
Yes.
Very good, Stan.
Hot potato, hot potato.
For some reason, that one shot, it was in space for no reason.
Oh, yeah, there was a couple of shots there. It's like nighttime, daytime, nighttime, daytime.
It's like, here, Apache throws it, and it's flying through space. I go, what a hell of a throw. Holy shit.
Quick, install it.
Put the thing in the thing. Hurry.
Put the lotion in the basket.
We don't want to get the hose again.
They look jazzed again. I love Loop of the Swing.
Mm-hmm. So this battle is just a distraction. Transform the fuck out of it. Transform harder than ever before.
That's what she said.
City versus city, basically.
One second, Stout.
Here, take a mountain to the face.
What's going on?
He's asking me about something. And I'm having problems focusing.
Okay.
You and me both, brother.
Oh, I already forgot. Damn it. Right, okay.
Boom! The rest of the city around them is just dwarfed by them.
There we go. It took me entirely too long to figure it out. We're in the club, stealing, picking,
and we'll never see Trypticon again. Not really. Oh, look, it's a miscolored ratchet in the background.
Limited palettes. It had limited palettes.
Uh-huh. Damn it. I was hoping they'd forget about the down position thing. See, that was pretty cool. Oh no. Idiot.
The hell? It's the on ice switch.
Go.
Alrighty.
Yeah! Fucking A, Spike.
Take a shot, Matt.
Let's do a shot!
Oh, heartburn.
Oh, were you asleep? I'm sorry, Chumunk. Meow. What the fuck's going on?
Yes, that's what happens when you live in Middle Tennessee. People cut their mufflers off because they think it's cool.
Oh, isn't that technically against most county laws?
It is. It's called a sound ordinance. Yes.
I thought that was like a crop duster flying right over your house.
Yeah.
That was so loser.
It sounded like me walking through Target with gas.
I'm so cool. Can I be you just for one day?
I feel so much better about myself.
There you go. Final line of the episode. We have looked into the face of our creator and seen the face of an enemy.
Commercial.
Sean just explained that was the last line.
Yeah. That's it. It's over.
Told you I'm having problems focusing.
Yes. You are.
That's the perfect way to watch Insidious.
What?
I watched it tonight. Jesus.
So, Stout, you were,
you're kind of
shitting all over Transformers the other night when you were drunk. How about now?
Stout?
What do you mean, shitting? I was not shitting all over Transformers.
Oh, do we need to find the video?
Sounds like a mess.
No, he was explaining he never really got into it when he was younger. He was shitting on it.
No, he was shitting on it. He was just taking steaming, diuretic dump all over it. You know, my childhood was better than yours because I watched the stuff I liked, and the stuff you liked is kind of.
I watched the GoBots and I watched the Rugrats.
And Rock
I was trying to explain that I was too young to understand Transformers because there was too much.
I was too young to understand. If anything,
Is like a good thing to say about Transformers.
Nice.
It takes more than 2 year olds
and had no idea.
It's more than meets the eye.
But I'm surprised you didn't let me see it later in its run or in Generation 2. I'm surprised you didn't watch it then.
Yeah.
That's all I'm saying.
Just didn't happen to catch it again.
I mean, that, it is what it is. I'm just, you know.
So, you know, after you know Season 2. Being kind of hit and miss. Definitely better during the latter third of it, I think. We started to get touches of the lore and stuff. And now, of course, we're into Season 3, which is very lore-heavy. Yeah. So what are you thinking now? After...
I just want to be a dick and be like, boring.
Well, this is actually kind of worse than it was before.
I mean, the writing's better, but the characters are just stupid.
You racist bitch.
And by the way, Matt, speaking of Robotech, we will be doing that next year.
So oh, cool. Fuck yeah, that'd
it
be
is
awesome.
The 30th anniversary next year.
Awesome.
So, yeah, we're
going to do... much fucking shit to watch next year. Holy crap.
I know.
Well, yeah, there's so much you can watch this year.
Well, I keep saying the big ones for next year would be, Robotech, Thundercats, Jason the Wheeled Warriors, and Mask. Those are the four big animated ones. And then it's the 30th anniversary of Back to the Future next year. You do the Back to the Future trilogy.
20th anniversary of Mighty Max, I think.
Is it? Was that 95?
I think it was 95, or it's this year, 94.
Mighty Max we could blow through in like a week. It's only 40 episodes.
So fucking good. Also not officially released, I don't think.
No, it's sadly not. But it's...
It's 93. Darn it, I was off by last year.
So we missed it. Oh, well.
Yeah, it was 93-94 season, which is why I was equating it to 94.
So we'll do that one in 3 years.
Yeah, sounds like a plan.
But so we got lots of the big cartoons to do and some random movies.
Twin Peaks was the other one.
Twin Peaks, yes, Twin Peaks.
And wasn't X-Files 93 or was that 92?
X-Files, I believe.
Didn't that start
now
like
1990,
actually?
No, X-Files is 90. X-Files, I believe, is 93.
Go, 93. Internet. 93. There we go.
That's it. The reason I knew that is because I watched it when I was in my last apartment in Winnipeg, and that was in 1993-94. So, yeah.
So we missed that, right. So we got 3 more years for that one.
Yeah. That's okay. We'll be fine. Oh, Babylon 5. When did Babylon 5 first come out?
Let's find out. Oh my god, typo.
96.
It was like 93 or 94.
94. Yeah, it's out this year.
It was 94?
Yeah.
Oh my god, it's this year? Yeah, we can't do that this year.
So So well, 5 years from now.
Maybe we'll celebrate. Well, we can do it 5 years from now.
Or we can
just, or we could just pick an arbitrary anniversary in between the 25th and 30th.
The
22nd.
We could do that. It's not like we actually need a reason to watch things. But it's nice to give it a sense of occasion, you know.
Yeah.
Alrighty, that is it from us, and it for the group viewings, actually, for the next 2 weeks. I'm probably going to sneak a few solo ones in over the course of that time. I know.
I was going to suggest that, actually.
Yeah,
I know a lot of you have been wanting to do some more Batman movies, so I might do some more of the Batman ones.
Try to let me know as soon as possible, so I can put them on the calendar for the week or whatever.
Yeah. You know? Well, I mean, the last one I didn't really plan. It just kind of randomly ended up on.
And that's fine, too, as long as you let me know to put you on air, you know.
But there's the other Batman movies. I'd like to do some of the animated ones as well, actually. There's some other anniversary things. There's Last Starfighter is 30 this year. Dune is 30 this year. What else? I know we all want to do Ninja Turtles, so I'll save Ninja Turtles.
Ninja Turtles.
Damn, I can't remember. I don't know. There's a bunch of stuff. I'll pick something. We'll do something. And given that all my free time won't be taken up with group viewings, I'll be doing some videos again. Yay!
Yeah. Also, but, maybe some fucking Twitch, maybe?
Oh, that's actually a really good idea.
I don't know about you fucking Twitch, but I'm not fucking Twitch.
I'm pretty much pretty much ready to go on Twitch. The only thing I'm still waiting for is my new PS3 hard drive. It still hasn't arrived. Hopefully, it should arrive this week coming up. I don't foresee it taking that much longer. So, yeah, I don't know. But, I mean, I can still do stuff without it. So, maybe. We'll see. We shall see. God.
Reboot started in 1994.
We already have too many anniversaries this year.
Damn it.
It's too many.
94 to 2002 is when it ran. Fucking.
I know. We'll do it eventually.
Don't worry.
That's what she said.
We'll do it in 2024.
That is totally my fault. You know, I should have known it being, you know, my favorite show as a kid of all fucking time.
It's a great show. Yep. Alrighty. We're going to go now, so we'll see you when we see you. We will be on for Saturday Night Insanity, then nothing changes with that. Just the group viewings are taking a break for a little bit, because apparently some of us are burned out right now and want a break, so we're taking a break. You know, I can keep going.
Of course, I return for the group viewings, and we stop for 2 weeks. Awesome!
Yay!
Sorry. Fine. Alrighty. See you next time, folks. Until then, thanks for watching, thanks for chatting, and sayonara.
Ines!